Look at that. It looks beautiful and classic.
Whoa, look at that, a staircase, and this looks pretty big.
Kitchen's nice, there's a window, there's a little strip of lights, there's a dishwasher, two baths.
And check this out, it's got its own built-in laundry room. How awesome is that?
And what's crazy is this building is over 100 years old.
Children's vitamins. They've got all the same stuff as adult vitamins, and they taste better.
This is where we're going today. It looks nice. That gym is probably for the whole, we'll see it shortly.
It seems I've misjudged my commute badly.
So I'm taking a quick break at the Time Warner Center, where the world's richest man will sell you vitamin water for $2. Jeff Bezos saving me 50 cents. Thanks, buddy. Or is vitamin water a loss leader, so you'll spend money at his bookstore? This is an Amazon bookstore right here. Look, they have a superhero book and a Will Smith book. He might be a real-life superhero. But check this out. The place we're headed to is 13 minutes away from this. It's freezing outside, and I don't really want to stand on the street for longer than I need to. That's how you get sick. I don't want to get sick.
Really, there is not a lot going on here in the morning, that is for sure. But they have a bathroom.
You can also check out the hideous statue.
These probably cost thousands of dollars.
And there's cafes and restaurants. I guess if you're in this part of town and you're like me and you have nothing to do, this is a good place to do nothing.
How you doing? Oh, thank you. That's right, I appreciate it, thank you. First day. New mask mandate where there's not full proof of vaccination required. I guess this counts. He was helping me out.
All right, train's like right there. We're on 103rd Street and Broadway, and I'm gonna need to see where I'm going. Look at how convenient this is. There's the train, there is the grocery store. Next to the grocery store is the discount store. Looks like there's a bunch of little restaurants across the street. This one's Indian. And if you don't like Indian, we have a noodle shop. If you don't like that, you don't get anything to eat. Not only noodles, stir-fried noodles, Mandarin noodles. And it's warm here under the plastic covering. If you're here, you gotta check out the Silver Moon Bakery. This place is pretty good. Plus, look at that. They've got handmade breads. I heard a rumor that it was cash only. I guess that works for me. By the way, all these restaurants that you see, this is all just one block away from the building. This place looks fun. Looks like an Italian place. I'd probably pick from the kids menu. Those look like options that I want. Pizza, love that. Then over here we have Cafe du Soleil. Is it a French place? It might be. Look at the outdoor dining. These are like little bubbles you can hang out in. Then we've got a deli that sells flowers. The last time I owed my wife an apology, I got her flowers from a deli. I think they look nice. I think they smell nice, but I owed her another apology after that, and I had to go somewhere pricier. Hey, awesome, man. Have a good one. Got some interesting buildings over here. Look at this. There's like half a townhouse right there in the middle of the block. Look at this thing. It didn't get torn down when they built that. It's a survivor. Either that or it's completely haunted. I'm gonna go with haunted because it's probably not true, but it's a lot more fun. More fun than believing that the owner was just some guy who didn't like money and owned New York real estate. Yeah, right. This is West End Avenue. The building should be one of those right over there. But check this out. Right next to the building, we've got this awesome park. It runs parallel to the West End Avenue. You can walk your dog, you can walk yourself. Just don't feed the animals, even if they look cute. And now that all the leaves on the trees are dead, you get a beautiful view of New Jersey right over there. It's funny how things have to die in order for you to see what a wonderful place it is. If your sarcasm detector didn't pick that up, it might be broken. And if it didn't pick that up, you probably live in New Jersey. I'm sorry about that. The street itself's pretty interesting. It's like all these really old school apartment buildings, very unique. Usually in New York, they have like some stupid business on like the corners, but not here, it's just all living. And annoying construction. What are these guys doing to that building?
And
Anyways, this is where we get to go. Look at that. It looks beautiful and classic.
It was beautiful. I wouldn't change a thing.
Santiago, how much we talking? What's the...
So right now it's $5,500 a month, and that includes heat and hot water. Never lived in an apartment. This is completely got renovated. It was created from two spaces. Downstairs below was never an apartment before, so you'd be the first tenant in.
I feel like this should cost more.
That's it. Well, it's rent stabilized apartment, so that makes a difference.
So even though I can't afford it at $5,500, since it's rent stabilized, I'll never be able to afford it. Look at how quaint the lobby is. Plus, we've got the elevator, so you don't have to take the stairs like a savage. Yeah, does this still work, or do you have to bring your mail outside like a savage?
Yeah, you gotta walk it down.
Why have we regressed as a society? Maybe because we don't fund the postal service. This all looks awesome. Check this out. You don't see this every day. And over here's the gym. Nice. There's people in the gym, but it's on the other side of that glass wall. And I see some bike storage way down there at the end. And there's also a really good looking laundry room here. Decent amount of machines, plus it's card activated. If you're a bookworm, you'll love the communal library. Whoa, is this a UFO conspiracy book? Which one of your neighbors put this here? You'll probably be able to find out immediately when you meet them in the laundry room. Apparently there's more than one thing available. This one is also for rent. Looks interesting. You can tell we're street facing, but I mean, this is another brand new apartment. Look at how sunny these rooms are too. That's interesting. How many beds, how many baths on this one?
Two bed, two bath.
How much?
This rent is $48.50.
I guess the one trade-off here is, I mean, you're not getting away from the fact that this is a street view, but I mean, it is a pretty cool street view, that's for sure. I love this kitchen too, and check out the fridge. It's one of those stealth fridges right here. If you have a stupid friend who eats too many snacks, maybe they won't find the fridge. They'll probably find the fridge. Now we're gonna check out this place, and if you guys wanna live here again, I'll have all Santiago's info in the video description. Subscribe as well, because we do this 6 days a week. Right next to the front door, which is right there, you've got this walk-in closet that's gonna be perfect for jackets. In fact, this whole little area by the front door, that would be great for like just kicking off your shoes. Maybe you could put some hooks on the wall or something. And maybe if you're a daredevil, you could put things along the edge of the staircase. Now from the staircase railing to the wall, we've got a living room that measures 13 feet 10 inches by 10 feet 2 inches. You could have a couch or something in that corner. You could have a dining table against this wall. The view that we've got here is not a street facing view. We're facing the interior, but you can see some natural light. And interestingly, over here by the jackets, there's like this little corner. You could do something with that as well. Not really sure what. But we've also got a big walk-in closet here as well. And since it has a light inside, and since it has a power outlet, I guess you could rent it out to one of your cheap friends. Seems like a pretty good kitchen. The appliances are all really nice. There's a lot of counter space, and look at this, right over here, got ourselves a sink sprayer, love that. The oven's super fancy, and above that, we've got ourselves a microwave. Plus, there's a window here as well, so the kitchen will get natural light, and you can air out your fumes from whatever it is you just incinerated on the oven. But I guess learning how to cook on YouTube, that's something people do, and you should give it a try. This is the bedroom, which is up here on the first floor. It seems big. And that's because it's 11 feet 7 inches by 10 feet 9 inches. We've also got two windows. These are each facing the back of the building, which we've already glanced at, so it will be nice and quiet. The closet's also pretty big, plus it has a little light inside, that way if someone's in here trying to scare you. Which is definitely possible. This is a pretty big closet. You'll be able to see them before that happens, hopefully. This is a pretty big basement. And not only is there a bathroom and the laundry room down here, it
has a secret exit that leads to where the laundry room for the building is.
That's where the garbage is, that's where we came out, and the gym and the laundry are right there.
If you're staying with your mother-in-law, you can quietly escape through the basement. She'll never know. Yes, she will. She'll probably say something nasty about you too when you do it, so don't do it. By the way, the building staff here are awesome. This is the half bath. It seems a little tight, but it's actually a pretty good size. And as far as half baths go, this is actually pretty nice. Sink's cute, plus look at that, we got a little, that doesn't open. This one does, we got a little storage beneath it. And above it, we have a nice looking medicine cabinet. Just around the stairs, we've got our own laundry room. This is fantastic. And this whole area is really spacious, 15 feet by 18 feet, 5 inches. You could do anything down here. But now that I've seen how big this is, I can't help but thinking that you might be better served by making this like a den. You have a couple couches, you have a big entertainment center, and then up the stairs, you make that all dining. And as long as you don't put a refrigerator down here, you'll have to come all the way up the stairs to get a snack from the kitchen, and that might help curb your appetite. Now the upstairs bathroom, this is a full bath, and that makes sense. The bedroom's up here. You're gonna need to take a bath or a shower somewhere, and here's where you'll be able to do it. We've got the same cute sink that we saw downstairs, same medicine cabinet. And the tub and shower combo that we've got here is pretty big. You'll be able to clean everything from yourself except emotional shame from too many snacks. I'm sorry if it seems like I'm being harsh on people who snack too much. That's actually me. Half the time when I'm talking to the camera and making fun of something, I'm actually making fun of myself. How else do you think I know how bad Dunkin' Donuts coffee is? I used to live in Massachusetts. But if you wanna live here in this awesome apartment, check out the video description for all the leasing agent's contact info, and then let's pick another video here or here. And I'll see you soon.